Good evening, I'm Stephen Cruz, and welcome to another high school football season with High School Rewind with Xfinity On Demand. Tonight, we take you to Alta High School as the Hawks host the Pleasant Grove Vikings. The big storyline tonight is Pleasant Grove head coach Les Hamilton's return to Alta. He won two state titles here in 2007 and 2008 back-to-back, and this is his first time back on the field versus the Alta Hawks. So big time game for him. I know he'd like to pick up the win. But for the Vikings, they have some big shoes to fill as they lost most of their senior leadership last year on last year's squad, who went 9-3 and had a quarterfinal loss in the playoffs. So Les Hamilton is hopeful that his juniors will pick up the slack on leadership and fill those shoes and hopefully start the season with a win here against his old team, the Alta Hawks. As for Alta, they had a rough season last year going 5-6, but still made the playoffs, finishing third in their region. They lost a lot of kids this year. They usually boast 85 to 90 kids on their squad, on their varsity squad, but this year only able to field 65 kids total because of the new high school Corner Canyon going in, taking a lot of their recruits. Head coach Bob Stevens understands the challenges his squad faces, but he's optimistic that they can perform at a high level this year and hopefully get a big playoff spot in Region 3. So let's head down to the field as the Alta Hawks host the Pleasant Grove Vikings. The Pleasant Grove Vikings will kick off to the Alta Hawks to begin the game. Back deep, Fabrizio and Christensen for the Hawks as Smith kick is away and the 2014 high school season is underway. It's fielded at the 10 across the 20 before he's tripped up, wrestles through his way across to the 30 before he's taken down, and the Alta Hawks will begin the drive at the 30-yard line, first and 10 for Alta. Not sure who the quarterback coming into the game was going to be, but it ended up being Braxton Kerr for Alta. There was a battle in camp to be the incumbent, and he's going to hand it off up the middle of the first play of the game. He's going to fight his way across the 35 and get taken down at the 36 for a 6-yard gain for Alta. It's going to be second down and 4 for the Hawks. Second down and 4 now for Alta. Carry previous by Josh Davis for 6 yards. Man in motion. It's going to be another handoff up the middle. And he's looking for room as he picks his way close to the 40 before he's wrestled down just short of the first down. He's going to be close to it, but about a yard short. Shotgun for the Hawks on 3rd and 1. 2 in the backfield split out. He's going to fake it to his left. He's going to hold on to it. Split it outside. Looking for room is Davis. Davis across the 40. He's going to be wrapped up and thrown down. The ball headed out of bounds, but it's going to be Josh Davis with a first down. That is number 39 for the Alta Hawks. We'll get his name on the next carry. It's going to be 1st and 10 for Alta. Trey Leota Hinken on the first down carry for the Alta Hawks. And now they're in business, 1st and 10 from the 45-yard line. Christensen now, wide pitch. He can't get it to his man, but he's going to dive on it and scramble for the ball and save the possession for Alta. And Kerr with the wild pitch to his man and wasn't able to complete it. It's going to be 2nd down and long now for Alta. 3rd and long for Alta after the fumble. Man in motion. He's going to hand it off to him on the end around. He's going to try and find some room before he's tripped up at the original marker. He's going to be short again. It's going to be 3rd and long for Alta. 3rd and long for the Hawks. One in the backfield, shotgun formation. They're going to pass for the first time. It's Braxton. He's going to fire over the dunk. And great defense. Is it broken up by the Vikings? That's number 14, Mitchell Price on the defense is going to force a 4th and out for Alta, and they will punt the ball away to the Vikings. Spread formation for Pleasant Grove on their first possession. High snap. It's going to be pulled down and handed off as he looks for him at the middle. Wide hole as he heads and scrambles for about a gain of 7. And before he's taken down just across the 45 or the 47, it's going to be a gain of 7 for the Vikings. Starting to drizzle here as the Vikings will pass. Under pressure, he rolls out his right. Across the middle, finds a wide-open man at the 45, and he's going to be wrestled down at the 44-yard line. And it's Christian Miller connecting with his tight end for a 1st down. There is a flag on the play as we await the call. Another penalty on the Vikings pushes them back 5 yards. It's going to be a handoff up the middle as he looks for room, but he's stacked up just short of the 30. It's going to be 3rd and about 20 for the Vikings. No huddle offense for the Vikings. Rain continues to pound the field. He's going to fake the handoff. Miller back to pass. It's a screen into the flat, but he's unable to hold on to it. And the ball is on the turf. We'll see who comes over. The Alta sideline is celebrating. There's no signal yet. It looks like it's going to be ruled an incomplete pass as Edwards was unable to field it on the reception. It's going to be 4th and 20 for the Vikings. The Viking drive netted more negative yardage than positive as the rain began, and we'll see how the Hawks deal with it as it's going to be a pitch to the outside, reverses field, but he's going to be pulled down in the backfield for a loss of about 5. And in nowhere to go as the Vikings defense smothers him in the backfield. It's going to be 2nd down and 14 for the Hawks. Both offenses struggling here early in the first game of the season, to be expected, where the defenses are pulling it off. Fake the hands off on the end around, hands it off up the middle, where he stacked up across the 50 on a short gain of 2. It's number 39, Treya Litika, or excuse me, Litoa Hankin on the carry. 3rd and long for Alta. Shotgun, 2 split out. He's going to hand it off in the middle, looking for room is Davis. Davis is going to break a few tackles down to the 45 before he's wrestled down near the original marker. It's going to be 4th and about 11 for the Alta Hawks after the short gain by Josh Davis. 1st and 10 from the 1 yard line, 3 in the backfield for the Vikings. They got to run it here. Ball possession is important. He breaks a move up the middle across the 5 before he's stacked up and driven back. He's going to get out to the 6 yard line though. So a big gain there on 1st down from inside their 5 as they get it out across 5 yard line to the 6. It's going to be 2nd down and 4 for the Vikings. 2nd down now, another handoff to the right side. Stacked up in the backfield this time, he's going to lose a yard, and that sends the Alta fans cheering as it's going to be 3rd down and about 5 for the Vikings. Filled on 3rd down for the Vikings, 5 wide. Miller back to pass. He's in the shotgun, steps to his right, fires over the middle. He's got a man, he's going to dive the ball. Did he pull it in? Looks like he caught it. And it's going to be a reception and a 1st down for the Vikings. That is number 12, Hayden Vinker. 19, Eli Herndon, who pulled it in for the 1st down for the Vikings. Formation, 5 wide. He drops the ball, puts it on the turf, but he's able to pick it up. And you got to think the rain had something to do with that, as Christian Miller able to recover the possession for the Vikings. It's going to be 4th down and long now, I believe, for Pleasant Grove. Correction, 3rd down and long for the Vikings. 5 wide, Miller back to pass. He pump fakes, looks for some room. He's in trouble. He's going to be swung down inside the 5, and a big-time sack by the Alta Hawks. That's number 45 of Alta. C.J. Packer, who pulls down Miller in the backfield. It's going to be 4th down and long, and the Vikings will be forced to punt. Alta 1st and 10 now at the 49. Rain is only getting worse. We'll continue to play on. Hands it off up the middle, looking for room. He's stacked up for a short gain. Looks like a gain of 3 for the Hawks. It's going to be 2nd down and 7 for Alta. 2nd and 7 for the Hawks. Lioto Hankin with the carry on the previous possession. Now the snap is going to be fumbled, and it's on the ground up for grabs, and it's picked up by a Hawk player across the 45 where he's taken down. Fortunate bounce for Alta as they maintain possession, and the rain is starting to affect ball skills as it's coming down even harder. 1:26 left here in the first quarter. 3rd down, split formation in the shotgun. Kerr back to hand it off. He keeps it. It heads up the middle for some room before he's tripped up across the 45. Going to be just short of the 1st down marker. Looks like about a yard, and Braxton Kerr takes it himself for about a 6 yard gain. Alta has a decision to make. It's going to be 4th and about 2. Beginning of the second quarter, the Vikings have a 1st and 10 from the 20 yard line, and it's Miller back to pass. He's going to hand it off up the middle. Big hole as Edwards breaks it free across the 30 before he's taken down, and it's going to be a 1st down for the Vikings on a 1st down carry. Excuse me, that was number 24, Hayden Pettis, the senior running back for the Vikings, that scampered for gain of 10. It's going to be now 1st and 10 from the 31 for Pleasant Grove. Somewhat of a hurry-up offense for the Vikings. It's another handoff to Pettis. Pettis takes it outside, looking for room. He's wrestled around and now gang-tackled by the Hawks before he's taken down for no gain. It's going to be 3rd down and long for the Vikings. 3rd and 7 for the Vikings. Shotgun formation, Pettis in the backfield. It's going to be pitched underneath to Edwards. Edwards looking for room, but he's stacked up in the backfield immediately at the 35-yard line. And Edwards is taken down. It's going to be 4th down and long for the Vikings, and they'll be forced to punt away. Handoff up the middle. It's going for nowhere. It's going to be second down at 10 now for the Hawks. Kerr in the shotgun, split out, has some trouble handling it, but he's going to hand it off. And oh, he's going to keep it and head up the middle and head across the 45, just short of the 50. And Braxton Kerr, again, on the quarterback option, does the right move and takes it up the middle for a gain of about six. It's going to be third down and five for the Hawks. Kerr in the shotgun, four wide, one in the backfield. Man in motion, snaps away, fakes the handoff in the middle. He's going to give it away, though. He's got some room on the outside, breaks a few tackles before he's tripped up and dragged down, and the ball's on the field. We'll see who comes up with it. They're calling it down, I believe. I believe that was Leota Hinken on the carry. And they're going to roll it down. Alta ball. It's going to be a first down for the Hawks. Alta hurry up offense. No time for Pleasant Grove to recover after the big carry. Another one up the middle. He finds a big hole. He's going to break a few tackles across the 30. Unable to get away from the last one before he's tripped up. And another big gain for Alta as they move the sticks inside the 30, and they're down at the 28. Alta once again on the move, not letting up. Low snap though, ball's on the ground, and Kerr will be forced to fall on it at the 35. Alta with two big plays and one step back. And they're gonna have a second and 15 from the 35-yard line. A lot of miscues due to the rainy weather. Low snap, now the ball's gonna be handed off on the outside, and Toledo to Heinken, and he's looking for room. He's gonna be tripped up and taken down low. Chopped down to the 30. Shotgun formation, third and long. Back to pass, he's under pressure. He's gonna try and get away, and it's incomplete. The Vikings swarmed Kerr, and he was unable to get it away. And that sends the Pleasant Grove sideline into a fury. It's gonna be fourth down and long now for the Alta Hawks. 5-yard penalty on the Hawks, pushes him back. It's fourth and long now. Kerr back to pass, he's gonna fire long. He's got a man, no. A little miscommunication between him and the receiver. It falls incomplete. Turnover on downs for the Alta Hawks. It's going to be Pleasant Grove ball with 6:20 left here in the first half. First and 10 for the Vikings. Officials taking time between each snap. He's going to roll out, actually, on the fake and no completion. Looking for his fullback in the flat. Number 44, Jake Giles, unable to get the completion. It's going to be second down and 10 now for the Vikings. Third and long for the Vikings, four split out wide. Doman and Wild to the spot on your screen. Under pressure is Christensen. Christensen looking for room at the 40, 45, 50. He's got the first down and more before he's taken down. And Christian Miller with the big carry for the Vikings gets into Alta territory with a first down at the 49-yard line for the Vikings. Penalty on the Hawks gives the yardage right back. It's first and 10 now from the 49 once again for the Vikings. So the rain continues to come down now. 5 minutes left here in the first half. The ref's doing a great job at toweling off the ball before each snap. Fortunately, the rain is continuing to pound the field, making it tough on the teams. Pass over the middle to Edwards. Edwards with a great catch and then a spin move at the 40. And Edwards with a big play. That's Coleman Edwards with a big play for the Vikings as he's taken down near the first down marker. We'll see if they give it to him. Looks like he's just going to be short. It's going to be second down and about a yard for the Vikings. Third and short for Pleasant Grove. Big backfield, it's Miller handing it off of the middle, and he's going to burst through a 40. Looks like he's going to be taken down near the first down marker. It looks like he'll have it. We'll see if they give it to him. Pettis with the first down burst. It's going to be first and 10 now after the measurement from the 40-yard line. Quick pass out to Edwards. Edwards unable to field it. It was backwards as they're going to play it as such as it heads out of bounds near the 45-yard line, and the pass from Miller to Edwards heads out of bounds, thankfully for the Vikings, as it was a scramble for the fumble. It's going to be second down and 15 for Pleasant Grove. Second down and long for the Vikings. Miller rolling out to his right. He's going to dump it off to Pettis. Pettis can't pull it in off his fingertips. The pass was a little bit off, but Pettis unable to reel it in, and the rain has to do something with that. It's hard to catch a wet football as the rain continues to pour. It's going to be third and long for the Vikings. Just over 3 minutes left here in the first half. Third and long for the Vikings. Four wide. Pettis in the backfield for Miller and the Vikings. He's going to launch deep. He's got a man. It's Doman. Doman pulls it into the 10. Doman fighting into the end zone. And Jacob Doman is going to stumble into the end zone after the big reception from Miller. And the Vikings are on the board. But there is a flag on the play. Pleasant Grove still celebrating. It looks like this one is going to be coming back, unfortunately, for the Vikings after the great pass from Miller to Doman. Touchdown called back by the Vikings. And now it's third and forever for Pleasant Grove, rolling out. And they're going to punt it away. The pooch punt hits the 45 and takes Pleasant Grove bounce into Alta territory. It's going to roll out and die near the 29, where the Hawks will take over. 2:40 left here in the first half, and the Hawks will have a possession to see if they can put some points on the board in their season opener. First and 10 for the Hawks. It's going to be a handoff up the middle. Leota Henkin looking for room on the 35, breaks a tackle as he heads towards the sideline, far sideline, stays in bounds. The clock will continue to roll, and Leota Henkin has a gain of 7 for Alta. Second down now for Kerr. Kerr's going to head off to Davis. Davis looking for room as he picks his way across the 40. It's going to be just short of the 45 at the 44, and Davis will have a first down for Alta. Set of downs for the Hawks after Braxton Kerr's run. Now it's a handoff to Davis. No, excuse me, good fake by Kerr as he keeps it, heads to the outside, but unable to find any room, and he's taken down for a loss of 4. It's going to be second down and 14 from the 45, 1:44 left here in the first half. First and long, now a handoff to Leota Henkin on the outside, breaks it across the 40. He's got some room down the sideline before he's dragged down at the 41, and a big time gain by Alta. It's going to result in a second down and about 5 for the Hawks. In the backfield, he's going to be handed off to Leota Henkin on the delayed handoff, but he's going to be wrapped up in the backfield and lose about 4 yards, almost back to the original line of scrimmage. It's going to be 3rd and 9 for Alta. 1 minute left here in the first half. The clock continues to wind. 3rd and long. Kerr back to pass. He's going to fire across the middle. He's got a man. He's dragged down to that 30. It's going to be a first down, though. First, it's Quinn Fabrizio on the reception as he catches it inside the 30 near the 27-yard line. And Alta with a fresh set of downs. 45 seconds left here in the first half. Alta threatening, 1st and 10 from the 27, and it's going to be another fake handoff, and Kerr will hold it up the middle as he's cut down just short of the 25, gain of about a yard for Braxton Kerr. Clock is still rolling, 30 seconds left as Alta hurries back to the line. Kerr spiked the ball, and now we have 23 seconds left in the first half. Kerr back to pass, he's going to step up in the pocket, fire to the far corner. He's got Fabrizio, but there's a fight for the positioning, and it falls incomplete. It's going to be 3rd down now with about 15 seconds left here in the first half. 3rd and 8 after the incompletion. 17 seconds left here in the first half. Kerr back to pass. He's got a man on the other side. He's got him in the corner, and he pulls it in. Big time reception for the Alta Hawks. And it's a touchdown to end the first half as time expires. Big time reception for number 81. That's Hayden Henrod with the touchdown catch for the Hawks to put them on the scoreboard to end the first half. Going to take a knee to end the half. The Vikings will head into halftime down 7-0 here at Alta High School. And we'll be right back with the second half of the 2014 season opener at Alta as they lead 7-0 over the Pleasant Grove Vikings. First and 10 from the 20 for the Vikings. Miller in the shotgun, Pettis to his right. It's going to be a handoff to Pettis. Pettis breaks it outside to the 30, and he's got some room down the sideline. He breaks away, trying to get away from his last man at the 45, and he's dragged down from behind by the Hawks. That's a touchdown-saving tackle by Luke Christensen, and that's a big gain for Pettis. It's going to be 1st and 10 for the Vikings. 5 wide for the Vikings. Miller in the shotgun. Snaps away, he's going to pass. Miller back, he's got a pocket, but now he's struggled and thrown to the ground. It's going to be a big-time sack by the Vikings. 3rd and long for the Vikings after the sack. Miller in the shotgun. He's back to pass. Under pressure once again. Steps up, rolls out to his right. He's got some room. He's going to launch it downfield to Edwards. Edwards goes up for it, and he looks like he pulled it down from the indication by the Vikings sideline. Big time celebration as Coleman Edwards pulls it down for the first down into Alta territory, and the Vikings are on the move. Second and 10, the Vikings opening up the playbook. A little bit more passing this second half, and it's going to be a handoff to Pettis as he breaks through the hole to the 30-yard line. Gain of about four for Hayden Pettis. It's going to be third down and a little over 5 yards for the Vikings. Third down, Miller in the shotgun. Four wide, man off to his left, and he's in motion. It's going to be a handoff to Edwards. Edwards looking for room. He's going to be wrangled in the backfield. Tries to find a seam and can't do it. And he's wrestled down for a loss. And the handoff to Coleman Edwards goes nowhere. Vikings lose about 3 yards. It's going to be fourth and 9 for Pleasant Grove. Fourth and long for the Vikings, and they're going for it from the 37-yard line. Miller in the shotgun. Pettis to his right. He's got some time as he launches towards the sideline, and it's pulled in. We'll see if he was able to catch it. It looks like it's going to be a catch for the Vikings. And that's Malik Overstreet on the reception, and it's going to be first down Pleasant Grove. First down Vikings after the big fourth down reception by Malik Overstreet. And it's going to be a pitch up the middle to Coleman Edwards. Coleman looking for room as he fights his way across and gets minimal yardage. Edwards with a gain of one, second down and 9 for Pleasant Grove. Second down for the Vikings. It's going to hand it off. No, not to Pettis. He's going to fake it, roll out to the near sideline, drop it off into the flat to his running back, Coleman Edwards. And Edwards dives over a player at the 10, and Edwards is chopped down at the 11. It's going to be another first down for the Vikings as their offense is in full motion now. We'll see if they can punch it in and knot this game up. Vikings knocking on the door. Miller's going to hand it off to Pettis. Pettis spins his way, fights down to the 5 before he's wrestled down. For a nice little gain for Pettis, 6 yards. It's going to be second down and about 4 for the Vikings inside the 10-yard line. Vikings threatening to score. Miller going to hand it off to Gannon Pettis. Pettis is going to shake off a tackler at the 7, fight his way, and Pettis shows the strength, and the Vikings are on the board behind the legs and strength of Hayden Pettis. And Pettis fights off multiple tacklers to get into the end zone. 6-7 now, the Vikings score in this second half. Pending the extra point, they can tie it up here. 7:37 left here in the third quarter. Kerr in the shotgun. Leota Henkin in the backfield, 3 wide for the Hawks. Man in motion is Fabrizio. It's going to be a handoff to Fabrizio. Fabrizio looking for room across the 25. And he's going to be back to the line, original line of scrimmage. That's Quinn Fabrizio on the end around. It's going to be second down and 10. No gain for the Alta Hawks. Second and 10 now. Another end around, but Kerr's going to keep it. Kerr breaking a tackle upfield at the 30. Kerr lowers his shoulder and fights for extra yardage near the 33-yard line. And Braxton Kerr with a nice little run there for the Hawks. It's going to be third down and about 6 for Alta. Man in motion for the Hawks, fakes the handoff. It's going to go up the middle to Leota Henkin. Henkin's going to fight his way across the first down marker. And Leota Henkin scrambles his way across the 35 and just short of the 40. He's going to be taken down at the 38, but it will result in a first down for Alta. At least it should be. They may have to measure. It's going to be close. Leota Henkin on the first down carry for the Hawks. Moves the chains. It's now first and 10 from the 38. Kerr is going to hand it off, and the ball... No, not fumbled. Leota Henkin just wrapped up in the backfield for a loss of about 3. Big time stop by the Vikings defense. Second and 13 after the loss. Kerr going to hand it off again. Henkin looking for room. He's going to be wrapped up in the backfield. And the Vikings defense showing up big time here on this drive as they are forcing the Hawks back. It's going to be third and even longer now for Alta. Third and long for the Hawks. Kerr going to fake the handoff, roll out to the near sideline, looking downfield. He's going to fire into the flat. He's got a man, but the Vikings are all over him. They're going to wrap him up and take him down near the 35-yard line. And the Vikings defense with a big stop on Alta. Josh Davis on the reception for the Hawks, and he will get 1 to 2 yards. And it's going to be fourth and about 13 for the Hawks. Alta will be forced to punt on fourth down. The snap's away, punt's on its way. Edwards will field it near the 30. Edwards looking for room to make a play. He's got the sideline and a few blocks down. 50-yard line, makes a man miss, and he's going to slide down near the 40. After a few nifty moves from Coleman Edwards, ignites the Pleasant Grove sideline, and the Vikings will have great field position for this next drive. 3:54 left here in the third quarter. 30-yard return by Coleman Edwards sets up the Vikings in Alta territory. It's going to be handoff to Pettis as he lowers his head across the 40. He's going to be taken down at the 42, 2-yard gain by Hayden Pettis. Second down and 8. In the backfield with Christian Miller. Miller back to pass. He's looking over the middle. He's got a man. It's Doman. Jacob Doman goes up high and grabs it at the 30. Makes, slips a tackle before he's wrapped up at the 31, 32-yard line. Jacob Doman with the first down reception for the Vikings. And the Pleasant Grove offense is on the move once again. Successful drive on their last possession ended with a Hayden Pettis touchdown. We're knotted up here 7-7. 3:15 left here in the third quarter. And Christian Miller back to pass once again. He's going to fire over the middle. He's got a man. It's Doman. Once again, slips a tackle, cuts it outside, and cuts upfield near the 10-yard line. And Jacob Doman with his second reception on this drive. And he's down at the 10-yard line. Another fresh set of downs for Pleasant Grove. Four wide for the Vikings. The rain is starting to pick up again. Miller back to pass over the middle. Little short. Can't quite get it to his open receiver. It was Coleman Edwards in the middle of the end zone. Unable to get it there. It's going to be third down and goal from the 11 for the Pleasant Grove Vikings. Third and 11 for the Vikings. Miller back to pass. He's going to fire to the far side. He's got Overstreet over there. Overstreet tries to dive for it. There is a flag on the play. We'll see what kind of penalty it's going to be, as Overstreet was unable to bring it in. Defensive penalty on the Hawks. It's now third and goal from the 6-yard line. Miller will roll out on his right. He's got a man in the flat. He dives it off, pulls in the touchdown, and that's Coleman Edwards in the flat on the reception. And Edwards picks up the touchdown for the Vikings and gives them the lead. 13-7, Vikings on top of Alta with 2:12 left here in the third quarter, and the Vikings have a chance at the extra point. Smith on for the Vikings. The kick is up and blocked, and no good. The Hawks come away with the special teams effort to block the kick of the Vikings, and the Hawks will have the next possession, trailing 13-7 to the visiting Vikings. First and 10 from the 35 for the Alta Hawks. And it's Kerr back to pass. Kerr's going to fire over the middle. He's got a man at the 50. 50 is going to be dragged down. And it's going to be a first down by Josh Davis, who reels it in at the 50-yard line before he swung down. First and 10, Alta Hawks. Second down, shotgun formation. Two split out for Braxton Kerr. Kerr back to pass. He's got a man in the flat. Off his hands, can't able to pull, unable to reel it in. It's number 20, Josh Davis. And it's going to be third down and 9 for the Hawks. Kerr in the shotgun. Leota Henkin in the backfield. He's going to be back to pass. He's got time, steps up in the pocket. He's looking to run. Goes to his left, jukes a man before he lowers his shoulder and dives for extra yardage at the 44-yard line. It's going to be short of the first down by about 4 yards. Fourth and 4 for the Hawks. Fourth down, and the Hawks elect to go for it. Kerr in the shotgun, two split out. Davis. It's going to be a handoff to Leota Henkin. Hankins finds some room on the outside of the 40. 40's breaking down the sideline at the 30. At the 21, man to beat. Leota Henkin stumbles down to the 10 before he's wrapped up and tackled by Will Overstreet on the touchdown-saving tackle, but not before Leota Henkin takes it down inside the red zone for the Hawks. And the Alta Hawks are looking to take the lead here late in the third quarter. First and goal from the 15, and Braxton Kerr will fire to the far sideline. And it looks like it's going to be a touchdown on that far sideline. Able to reel it in is number 3, Quinn Fabrizio. Big-time catch by the Alta Hawks, and they've tied it up 13-all, pending the extra point. Hawks here at home, season opener, start the fourth quarter out with a touchdown from Braxton Kerr to the far sideline to Quinn Fabrizio. We're all knotted up, 13-13. First and 10 for the Vikings. Miller in the shotgun. He's going to fake the handoff to Pettis. Fire over the middle behind his receiver, but it's pulled in. And that's Jacob Doman on the reception. Pulls it in just short of the 30 at the 29-yard line. Tough catch by Doman, but he's able to reel it in just short of the first down. Second and a couple for the Vikings. Second and about a yard for Pleasant Grove. Back to pass again is Miller. He's going to fire over the middle. He's got a man, but it's almost picked off by the safety, Luke Christensen. Unable to snag it, but breaks it up in the process. Dangerous pass there for Miller, and it's going to be third down and about a yard for the Vikings. Pleasant Grove with a hurry-up offense. Miller in the shotgun. He's going to hand it off to Pettis. Pettis fights his way across the 40 before he's wrapped up and taken down at the 42-yard line. Short gain for the Vikings. It's going to be second down and about nine for Pleasant Grove. Second and nine for the Vikings. Miller in the shotgun. Pettis to his left. He's back to pass. He's got plenty of time. He's going to fire out to the flat. He's got a man. Goes up and grabs it. And that is number four of the Vikings. Matthew Wild, also the backup quarterback, who moves the sticks for the Vikings. First and 10 from the 47-yard line for the Vikings after this, the reception by Wild. And the Vikings offense, completely different look here in the second half. It's going to be a handoff to Pettis. Pettis fights his way across the 45, still fighting for yardage before he's dragged down just short of the 46. It's going to be a short gain for Hayden Pettis. Defensive holding penalty gives the Vikings great field territory at the 30 and a fresh set of downs. First and 10 for Miller and the Vikings. Miller back to pass, fires to Jacob Doman on the slant. He's got some move at the route 20, cuts it outside of the 10. Jacob Doman looking for the sideline before he's wrapped up at the 7. Jacob Doman in the open field. Vikings knocking on the door. It's Miller, hands it off to Pettis. Pettis looking for room, and he's stacked up at the 5. Nowhere to go. The Alta Hawks defense holds this time. 5 wide, Miller alone in the backfield. He's going to try the handoff. No, the ball ends up on the floor, but Miller picks it up, and he's fighting his way for yardage. As he swung down close to the end zone, looks like he's going to be just short. The officials are signaling that he's down at the 1. And Christian Miller somehow picks it up off the ground after the handoff was bobbled, and it's going to be 4th and goal from inside the 2-yard line. 4th and goal, heavy backfield for the Vikings. And it's going to be Miller handed off to Pettis. Pettis picking his way. He's going to be stacked up. Let's see if he can fight his way to the end zone. And it's going to be a touchdown. The referee gives the signal as Hayden Pettis finds his way into the end zone for the Vikings to give them the lead 20-14 pending the extra point. Vikings will go for 2 after they miss the extra point. And it's into the flat again, looking for Edwards. No, in the back of the end zone, and it's caught. It's Malik Overstreet with the 2-point conversion on the reception. The defense keyed on Edwards, and Miller found Overstreet wide open in the back of the end zone. Great play call by the Vikings coaching staff. And it's going to be 21-14, 7-point lead by Pleasant Grove. And starting to pick up once again as Alta begins the drive. At the 29-yard line, it's going to be a handoff to Davis. Davis looking for room on the outside. He's going to be wrapped up just across the 30 for a short game. Josh Davis on the carry for the Hawks. It's going to be second down and 9 for Alta. Split backfield in the shotgun formation for the Hawks. Kerr back to pass. Two-step drop, fires out of the far sideline. He's got a man, but he's taken down by Doman. Doman was there to clean it up, and no gain by Josh Davis, who caught it in the flat for a short gain. He was unable to turn up field as Jacob Doman wrapped him up. It's going to be a short gain now, third and about 7. Third down for the Hawks, 4 wide, 1 in the backfield. Kerr rolling out to the far sideline, looking in the flat. Got a man, and he's caught it near the 40-yard line, near the first down marker. And it looks like it's going to be a first down for the Hawks. Big time reception for Alta. 3 wide for Alta. Christensen coming into the backfield to the left of Kerr. Split backfield, shotgun formation. He's going to hand it off to the outside, looking for room. Kerr keeps it, and he's wrapped up and gang tackled near the line of scrimmage. Braxton Kerr with nowhere to go on the quarterback option. And he's taken down. It's now going to be third and long for Alta. Third and long, 5:40 left here in the ballgame. Alta trailing 21-14 to the Pleasant Grove Vikings. Kerr back to pass. He's got a man over the middle. It's broken up. almost picked off by the Vikings. Josh Ross, the linebacker, was there to break it up, and it's going to be fourth and long as Alta will elect to punt. Low snap, it's on the ground. He's going to be round in the backfield, and the ball is still up for grabs. The Vikings are fighting for it, and it looks like regardless they will have it. It'll either be their turnover on downs or a punt or a fumble recovery, and the rain definitely affected the punter on that one as he was unable to get the snap clean off and get the punt away. And it's going to be a turnover. So there was a scramble for the ball near the 25-yard line. After the fumble on the punt, the Vikings will take over with great field position near the 24-yard line. Miller in the shotgun. He's going to hand it off to Pettis. Pettis looking for room across the 35, taken down just short of the 20 at the 22-yard line. Hayden Pettis with a short gain of about 3 or 4. It's going to be second down. 5:05 left here in the ballgame. Second down for the Vikings. Miller in the shotgun. Does hand it off to Pettis. Pettis finds a crease up to the 15, and he's going to be taken down near the first down marker. Hayden Pettis takes the handoff on the quarterback option from Miller and takes it down near the first down marker. We'll see if they give it to him. Third and less than a yard after the carry by Hayden Pettis. 4 minutes left here in the ballgame, and the Vikings are threatening once again. Another handoff to Pettis. He lowers his shoulder and looks for the first down marker, and he will have it inside the 15-yard line. Clock continues to roll. 3:45 left here in the ballgame. Vikings up 21-14. Miller, another handoff to Pettis. Pettis breaks it outside, and Pettis is going to walk into the end zone. Great moves in the open field by Hayden Pettis, and he will score his second touchdown of the ballgame. Big-time run by Pettis to seal this one. Now they are up 27-14, pending the extra point with just over 3 minutes and 30 seconds left here in the ballgame. Kerr in the shotgun, four wide. He's back to pass, looks over the middle. He's going to fire out of the near sideline to Josh Davis. Davis lowers his shoulder at the 50, fighting for yardage before he's taken down. He's going to have a first down. Reception by Josh Davis. He's going to move the chains. 3:15 left here in the ballgame. Second down to 10. Back to pass, short pass over to Fabrizio. Fabrizio down near the 40s. He's spun down at the 39. Just short of the first down. It's going to be third and one for the Hawks. Hurry up offense. Kerr back to pass once again into the flat. It's Davis. Davis is going to slip out of bounds just across the 40, just short of the 45. It's going to be a first down for the Hawks. First and 10 from the 44-yard line. 43, excuse me. Kerr back to pass again. Steps up. He's going to be swarmed by the Vikings. Somehow slips away and gets back to the line of scrimmage. And Braxton Kerr, somehow under pressure, is able to slip away and get back to the original line of scrimmage. It's going to be second down and 10. Vikings defense playing it very well. The bend but do not break. Don't want to give up the big play to give the Hawks a chance. Kerr rolling out to his right. He's got a man on the far sideline, and he gets hit as the ball gets there. Well defended by the Vikings. It's going to fall incomplete. Fourth and 10 now for the Hawks. Huge play for the Hawks. This could decide it all. Fourth and 10 from the 43-yard line. Kerr back to pass. He's going to fire over the middle. It's knocked down, almost picked off, but it doesn't matter. That will result in a turnover on downs, and the Vikings will take possession with 2:07 left here in the ballgame, and they lead 28-14. Defensive penalty on the Hawks will result in a first and 10 and into Alta territory. They're at the 47-yard line. 1:49 left here in the ballgame. Miller going to hand it off to Pettis. Pettis picking his way. He's out across the 40 to the 35 to the 30s. It breaks a few more tackles. And Hayden Pettis with a first down and another big run for him and the Vikings. First and 10 at the 29. Vikings almost in the victory formation. They'll hand it off one more time to Pettis. Pettis stacked up at the line of scrimmage before he's taken down. The clock continues to roll. 1:05 left here in the ballgame. Vikings will take the game 28-14 here at Alta. Big win for Pleasant Grove. Vikings roll out the victory formation. 30 seconds left here in the ballgame, and Miller will take a knee, much deserved, as the first half was filled with flags and not a lot of offense, mostly defense. The second half exploded wide open for the Pleasant Grove Vikings. 28-14, they'll take the victory here at Alta. And next week, Pleasant Grove will be in California taking on Torrey Pines High School, Friday, August 29th, that is, while the Alta Hawks will be at Lone Peak to play an in-state team. And the Vikings are celebrating on the road this week in the season opener. Pleasant Grove again wins 28-14 over the Alta Hawks here at home. For High School Rewind and Xfinity On Demand, I'm Stephen Cruz.